Don't give up faith. Don't give up the hope. The American dream is waiting for you. Now.
She's my sister.
She has to be deported.
Magda, obiecujem ci.
I have a feeling about her. She could be special.
Can you help me?
Oh, absolutely. Because I liked exploring male emotions, weaknesses in a way, what are perceived as weaknesses, and I just decided to dispense of all macho aspects, because what is considered feminine, I mean culturally, not biologically, it's kind of more openly emotional, more willing to discuss or address kind of a person's wants or needs in a more direct fashion, is more appropriate for melodrama, which is a very beautiful thing. If melodrama is told with honesty and directness, it's, for me, the most beautiful dramatic art form.
This is Ava.
But it'd take a lot of money to get them out of there.
Or a lot of fucking.
What do you want here in America?
I want to be happy.
And now, Lady Liberty opens her arms to you. How much more she comes out depends on you.
I know you judge me.
I don't judge anybody.
So I decided to try to just dispense with all macho and to tell something that was as emotional as possible. Well, this was very difficult for him, because he hated his character, you know, and he was so miserable because he's playing somebody filled with self-hate, and always a liar. Everything is a lie, everything is a manipulation, filled with self-loathing. So he was not a happy person on the set, and he would often say to me, "Why are you making me do this? Why are you making me do this?" I said, "What do you mean? You chose to be here. Chose to explore that part of you." He was so unhappy.
You do not take her.
Let me guess. You're falling for her. I'm going to help you get your sister.
So, it depends on the character he's playing. Sometimes if he's playing another type of person, he can be really, a joy. But it's not to say he was not good to work with. He was amazing, but he just, dealing with this type of person, he was always in a state of real unhappiness. Well, there are two other movies which have Low Life in the title, and. You know, I didn't want it to be confused with another movie, so there was that, and I wound up thinking that Low Life lacked poetry. It's not exactly what I wanted to communicate. Plus, it was a little misleading. People thought that, you know, I wanted the title to be ironic, but people, I think, were thinking I was looking down on them, and I didn't want that. So I decided to go. See, when I look at all these operas that I love, the titles are very direct. You know, they're the name of the character or something. You know, there's not anything really fussy about them. So I just decided to be very straightforward with the title. Oh, it was incredible. I love Darius. Darius and I had an incredible relationship. And, you know, I have great joy when I work with a collaborator to whom I can say very little, and they seem to understand what it is I want. So Darius and I talked a great deal, but not during the shoot. We talked a great deal before the shoot, and then while we were shooting, he and I just sort of looked at each other and nodded, because he had already understood what it is I was trying to go for, And as is a beautiful thing, he brought more to it than what I had originally asked for. And that's a great gift. I love him. I love him as a person, too. I think he's a beautiful man. A beautiful person. So when you work with a beautiful person, it becomes much more fun, you know. There's no arguing or anything like that. I would love to work with him forever. It's tough because, you know, he's very in demand, so your schedule has to match his, but in the next film I do, I hope I work with him again.